Catherine has talked before about something she came up with called Final Frenzy, where, you know, when she was really up against it, she needed to get these shots and get these done. Can you just talk a little bit about sort of working under those conditions?
Basically? Unbearable. I mean, I think we should have been paid more.
Matt,
she's nuts. I mean, she's tree for the parrots crazy. And when that shit goes down, it's just, you want to leave.
Yeah, concur. Done. Let's just...
With legends like Gary Oldman and Julie Christie, how was it? Were you going to them sort of with questions? Were they coming to you sort of telling you anecdotes and stories and things like that?
When my fear subsided at those few moments when I was around Gary Oldman, I would kind of talk to him about things. I really loved the film that he directed called Nailed My Mouth. Mm-hmm. And I was interested in kind of hearing about that story and how he did that. It was an incredible film. For me, it was mostly stand back, keep your mouth shut and your ears open.
Absolutely.
And just take note of you know, the difference that these actors bring to their roles and what makes them so special.
The other thing, of course, you have to act alongside is a CGI wolf who is not there most of the time, you know, stays in his trailer, doesn't want to come out, talks to the agent.
It's very difficult.
Is it an interesting experience trying to sort of just act alongside something that's not there and acting scared against, you know, a piece of polystyrene that's threatening you at any one moment?
You know, there's a reason in the theatre they call plays plays, because you have to play. And it's weirdly easy to open that part of your mind that lets you become like a child again. And that's all you really have to do, just open your imagination. We have Catherine Hardwicke, who encourages, because she's crazy, she encourages that kind of behaviour. So it was fun.
Amanda was part of the sort of the team that basically auditioned both of you. I mean, she must have. She told me she picked a favourite, but I won't tell you who was the favourite because that would just cause horrible ructions between the two of you.
There have been people who are less diplomatic than you, I must tell you.
So how was the audition process? Was it sort of fairly straightforward? Was it something you were nervous about?
Auditions are completely nerve-wracking to begin with. It's when it's a film that you really, really want, you try to kind of be stoic about it and put that fear aside, but you're just crossing your fingers and hoping like hell she responds to you, really.
And it's also, you know, behind the scenes, it's interesting when you find yourself in Los Angeles with 12 other actors, and we were doing chemistry tests, in the back room when you're waiting to go on, just how actors deal with that kind of pressure. Some people get very defensive, some people get very, you know, overcompensating, some people get very shy. It's just a strange little dynamic. It's a bit like The X Factor.
I just went and stayed in the makeup room.
I played
all
Jenga
by myself.
Jenga was great.
So we had. Yeah. No wonder we got there, because there was actually one boy who went in and came out and passed me in the hallway and said, you know, something like, "I've already got it," or "Yeah, wow. Good luck," or something like that. Where, yeah. And you're just kind of like, oh man, you know, something's going on with you there, friend.